Hello everyone, I'm Szymon Rybczak, a software engineer at Callstack, and this is the second episode of React Native Optimization Shorts. It's a video series in which we take Callstack Ultimate Guide to React Native Optimization from page to practice. My goal is to show you how by doing some simple development tricks, you can get really nice effects really fast. In this episode, we'll talk about upsides. Let's get started. When you are starting building your React Native app, you may not care that much about upsize. But the truth is, upsize is a really important part of your app. As you can see on the graph created by Twilio segment, it can have a huge impact on apps downloads. And as we can also read from another chart from CleverTap, almost 19% of users uninstall apps because of limited storage issues. In the Ultimate Guide to React Native Optimization 2024, we've covered a bunch of techniques to help you keep your app size small. Today, I would like to show you the one that requires to change just one Boolean value inside build.gradle. This value controls if the Java bytecode inside release mode is minifying or not. It's called enable prograd in release builds. Let's see where we can change it and what the result will be. Let's see how it works in practice. So here we have basic React Native project with some few native dependencies, just a normal React Native app. I would like to build up to check what is a initial size of the bundle. To build our production app, we can do it by running build Android command. So we need to type npx React Native build Android dash dash mode release. And let's wait a few seconds for our app to build. Perfect. Our app is ready. And let's check out the output directory. And here we have our app, which we just built. And as we can see, our app is 29 megabytes. It's okay result. But as I said, it's a new project. Let's see how on this small project, toggling the value in build.gradle will change the app size. Here is our file. And right now, all we need to do is to just toggle this value, enable prograd in release builds. Let's assign it to true. And let's back to our project directory and let's rebuild our app with the same command. Yeah, perfect. Our app is ready. Once again, let's go to the output directory. Let's run the command. And yeah, as we see that this is a new build, it's 2 megabytes smaller. On the small project, we have 2 megabytes smaller app build. And yeah, by toggling one flag inside build.gradle, our app is 2.5 megabytes smaller. And that was tested on pretty much new app with just few native dependencies. In the case of bigger app, the difference will be greater. To learn more about other flags that you can switch to get a smaller app size or other techniques, go check out our guide. It has 23 chapters filled with the most relevant tips and tricks to teach you how to handle performance issues better. You will find the link in the description of this video. And yeah, that's it for this episode of React Native Optimization Shorts. Our demo app is now a bit smaller, and I believe you can achieve more with all tips that are waiting for you in guide. See you in the next one. Bye.